So the rationale for the ICT and science unit we've designed for the school is sort of stems from the history of our teaching the pre-service teachers at the university, where I've taken them for a subject called teaching science. And Graham was involved with our project up there as the ICT expert to help us integrate the ICT into achieving our science learning outcomes. The background of that is, it comes from a few elements really. The science is not really something that is a text-based or an orally-based sort of understanding. In fact, it couldn't exist if it was only oral, and it's really multimodal and integrates diagrams and models sometimes, physical models, into the understandings.
If you imagine that the players are the soft, they're the soft particles, each player is a soft particle, and you ever see it in the footy when they've been a bit naughty and having a bit of a wrestle, and they all run in, and there's more and more of them there, and they're all in the middle having a wrestle? Here's my MCG, here's my players wrestling in the middle. So all 36 are in the middle, and they're all stuck together. So what I want you to imagine is you're in a helicopter, you're going up higher and higher and higher and higher, and you can see the big green oval, and you can just get to the point where you can just see those players all having a big hug in the middle.
So today we will be looking at our animations, and we've already talked a little bit about what software we'll be using. Who's using Pivot? 1, 2, 3. Is anyone else using the webcams? A couple there. And is anybody... we've already had one group use an iPad.
Yes, that was this morning.
So we might be able to elect another group doing that. And everyone's putting them together on Movie Maker?
So one of the things you were saying before about the simplifications is they'll want to include their son, and they always need some context, but you always just need to double check with them that they know that the son's simplification and what they're saying it is.
Yeah, so my role was, I'm based at Golden Square Primary School, and I was approached by La Trobe to go into the university and work with the lecturers. And I was introduced to Jim, and I spent one day a week with going to lectures and finding out what the particle model was all about and how chemistry fit in and what he was teaching in his with his students. And then Jim came up with these ideas about the particle model, and he said, what is the best way to represent that? And we went down the track of using stop motion software, and that's what the large part of this experience has been about with the students.
Can I look at your pivot, back at the pivot one? So what are you doing with these two stick figures?
Well, that's just, they're just the people that are going into the hot air balloon.
Okay.
When we're animating it.
So thinking about what we can do next time to make it more effective, and one of the things that got said by Kerry Ann and the students was the timeline of 3 weeks with the whole unit, getting to this use of the particle model and, including completing their animation.
Yep.
We were thinking that perhaps a little bit like that third year model, that we need to adjust the practicum aspect from the uni's perspective, where perhaps we've got a series of lead-in afternoons before the block practicum to give the students a chance to engage with the kids and find out what they know and get to know them, and then sort of bang, when the block practicum starts, you can be really into the meat of the unit.
And that was a theme that was going right through, is that the student teachers felt like it was crammed.
Yeah.
So I think it's important that the literacy at the moment is still being separated into other blocks, and the connection that they're doing with their storyboarding, that falls through into their literacy, and that the mentor teachers see that. The other aspects of it too is that we've had some meetings with Jan,
the practical coordinator.
Yeah. And she also mentioned the same thing, that this seems to be a flavour with some of the other schools that you're working with. So it would be great that if we could move some of that initial contact the student teachers have with the mentor teachers and with the classroom, the students.
So I guess what I'm hoping that I'll see even more, and there's signs from these students this year that they're developing this understanding, that the use of the ICT is as much about developing students' understandings of science concepts, and of science too, I suppose, but the concept especially with the movement about particles that it facilitates, is as much about that aspect than it is a summative assessment of their learning, kind of post hoc assessment of what they've learnt, that it's a formative assessment in that you can judge what the kids are understanding very visually all the way along and feed in to that. It's not to stand back and this is like a test. You're actually developing an explanation.
In what ways could your students demonstrate their content knowledge using ICT? What practical activities could you incorporate into a lesson to make a theoretical concept more understandable? How have you used external resources beyond your classroom to enhance your students' knowledge and understanding?